Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look into DaVinci Resolve 19 and the new tool, the Film Look Creator. And we're just going to play around with it and have a look at what we can create using the tool available now in DaVinci Resolve 19. So, without further ado, let's just jump right into DaVinci Resolve 19 and let's get started. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and we're going to have a look at the Film Creator tool, new in DaVinci Resolve 19. And the cool thing about this tool is that you can actually apply this in the edit page or in the color page. So we'll go up to our search bar under effects, and we're just going to search for film. And here we have the Film Look Creator. I'm going to apply this to this clip I have right here. This is shot on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K with a anamorphic lens. In this case, it's the Lauer 35mm anamorphs. I did do a video about those, so if you want to check that out, you can have a look at that up here in the top corner. Anyway, let's get going with the tutorial. So if we take a look in the inspector, we have the different settings. We have here a default 65mm. We have a default 35mm, which looks like this. Also, we have a cinematic look, looking like this. We have the bleach bypass look, looking like this. And then we have the nostalgia look, which is pretty cool. Then we have a default with no effects. So this is just going to take all of the effects off, because per default, all of these, the split tones, the vignette, the halation, the blooming, the grain, the flicker, the gate wave, the film grain, is more or less enabled. But if we're using this no effect, they all turned off. And then of course we have a custom as well. So for this thing, I'll just go with the default no effects. So if we're going to make a look and we're going to make that into a LUT, we can click right here. And this is going to take some of the different tools off, but that's not what we are going to do. The first setting you could mess around with be the color space overrides. So if we open up here, we can go in and change the different settings. We can input color space. We have an input gamma and output, all of these things. And I know that my input color space on this one is a Blackmagic white gamut 4-5, like that. And then for the rest of this, you could go in, but I'm just going to use my timeline settings. So we're going to take that out of the way. So the first thing we can change is the color settings. Things like exposure, where we can change the exposure like that. We have some contrast, so we can make it more contrasty, which is what we're going to do. We have some highlights. We can play around with the highlights and see a little here. So like that. Then we have a fade, and the fade is just going to fade the colors a little bit like here. In this case, I want to keep it like that. Then we have white balance settings. So we can change the white balance to something completely else. However, I think we're going to dial it in around here, I think. Then we have the tint, and we can, of course, change the tint. I'm not going to do that for this clip. So I'm just going to double click here to reset. Also, all of these things can be keyframed over time, which is kind of cool. We have a skin. I have no persons in this shot, so I can't really use that for anything. Next, we have subtractive saturation. And you can see that we're going to either take away saturation or we're going to boost up saturation. So I'll find a middle ground where I think it's good. Here looks good. Next, we have richness. And if we are uncertain of what that particular tool does, we can actually hover over the tool and there are going to be a pop-up menu telling us add depth and richness to the image. So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to add richness and depth to our image. I think we'll do something around here. Last on the list, we have the bleach bypass, which is this look coming from processed film. We can kind of go all the way up and make it very noticeable, but I think we could do something like this. So next up, we have split tones, and we can just enable them like that.
and we can go into the amount, and we can make like a little teal and orange look. We can also go into the hue angle and change the color we want, but I want to keep it here, something like that. And then we have pivot, where we can again shift the colors around. I think we'll leave it like that. Then we can add a vignette just by enabling it. We can change the size of our vignette and the amount of our vignette, so which looks okay. It's cool. Okay, so the halation tool is also here, and we can just go and enable it. And again, we have a amount, and we can also change the radius. So for this particular clip, I don't like the halation, so I'm just going to take it off. We have a blooming effect, and we're going to enable that. We can put in the amount blooming and the radius of the blooming. And again, for this shot, it's not doing a lot of things, but you can see in the corners that it's just blooming the highlights a little bit here. So we're going to keep that. Now we're going to come to the grain, and we're going to enable grain. I seem to like 35 millimeters, and we're going to keep that. And we can change the size of the grain, if you see. Now it's really grainy, and the amount, and all of these things. The softness of the grain, the saturation of the grain, and we can also image defocus if we want to make it defocus, but we don't want to do that. I'm going to change the size a bit, like that. I think it's cool. Then we have a flicker function. It's not really doing that much for this shot here, so we're going to take that off. Then we have a gate wave, and then we're going to enable that, and we can of course change things and the rate if we want to make, you can see it's going to make this more handheld stuff here. But this is a tripod shot, and I like it like this, so I'm going to take this off. We don't need to have like little handheld look. Last thing is film gate. We can enable that, and then we have different film gates here, with Academy, whatever. But again, for this shot, which was shot anamorphic, I'm not going to use that. And then the last thing, we have a global blend, and that's just how we're going to blend it all together, or mix all of the effects together. So maybe we are going to end up around here instead, something like that. Now we have this shot going from looking like this into looking just like this with the effect applied. So that's pretty cool. One thing to keep in mind is that if you are making the effect in the color page and you jump to the color page, you will see that you can't actually see that the grade is applied in the node. And maybe you're then having a lot of different clips and something is wrong, and you end up thinking you didn't add it or something, and you're going to add in the effect again, and then you're going to double up the effect, and it might make a lot of confusion in the end. So keep that in mind. Anyway, that was a look at the Film Look Creator, a super cool tool that's now built into DaVinci Resolve, even though it doesn't work like the Dehancer and some of the other plugins. This is a pretty cool tool, and I do believe that over time this is just going to get even better. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.